Hello all, welcome to my channel. I am Vivek Gaurav and I'll be teaching you dynamic programming. And before we go ahead, a humble request from my side, please like and subscribe to my channel and please click on the bell icon so that you'll be getting notified every time a new video is coming. Now, let's get started. Today we are going to talk about Python installation, that how you can install Python in your local machine. Okay, or how you can use Python in an online editor. So the topic that we are going to discuss today is that how to download Python, how to install Python in your machine, and then how to use IDE, which is integrated development environment, like PyCharm, Visual Studio Code, etc. And in case you are not able to download any of these, then how to use an online editor like REPL.IT and still able to say, you know, write your program, run your program and save your program as well. Okay, so let us go ahead and understand that. So the first is that how to install Python and what is the environment setup that you need to do. Now the important thing is that in order to become Python developer, which you want to become, that's the reason you are watching this video, right? So the first step is to learn how to install or update Python on a local machine or on your computer. And in this video, we'll discuss the installation of Python on various operating systems. Here I'll be, you know, focusing more on Windows because this is what I'm using, and I have taken the screenshot while I was installing it in my machine, right? So I'll be telling you all the steps, and then I'll be using various IDE and online editor to show you that how you can use that. So let's go ahead. So first of all, what you have to do is that you have to visit this link, which is www.python.org/download, to download the latest release of Python. And in this process, in this video, that what I have done is that we have installed 3.8.6, though after that I have updated it. So you'll find the release, the version of mine is a bit different one. Okay, so when we click on the above link, when we click on this particular link, the following page will bring. This page is the one. Okay, now this is a screenshot of the, like, you know, when I was installing it for the first time. Okay, that time the release date was October 5, 2020. Here you might find the, you know, a latest release date or something like that, so go with the latest version that you can find over there. Okay, now what you have to do is that select the Python version that you want to download and click on the download button. Here you can see the download button, you have to click on this. Then what you have to do is that once you have clicked or once you have downloaded it, then you double click the executable file. Now I know that you know all these steps. The reason I am making this, you know, video or tutorial is that the whole reason of that, sometime you are not able to do the setup because of some reason or the other, and then you reach out to us, right? That's the reason I thought of, you know, telling you all the steps which are involved to download it or, you know, using an online editor, so that you do not have any issue. In case you are still having any issues, you know, do write in the comment box. Or the second thing is that, you know, update it in the Telegram group or the WhatsApp group that you people are into. Okay, so the first thing is that double click on the executable file, which is downloaded, already downloaded, and the following window will open. Here you can see a window is coming up. Okay, now what you have to do is that select custom installation and proceed further and click on the add path checkbox. Okay, so here you can see that there is an add path checkbox. So what it will do is that it will add the, you know, add the path. Okay, it will add the path automatically. It will set the Python path automatically. You do not have to do that. Sometimes people do not click on that and then they have to go to the environment variable and do the setup. So you make sure that you click on this and then everything will be easy. Okay, and we can also click on the customize installation to choose desired location and feature if you wish to. Other important thing is that to install launcher for all the user must be checked, right? Launcher for all the user must be checked. This one should be checked. Then installation in process, then you will get a window like this, and as soon as it gets complete, you are already there, right? Now try to run the Python on the command prompt. Now how to get the command prompt, in case you are having that doubt, you press Windows plus R. Okay, then you will get a run window like this. There you will get a box, there you write cmd. Okay, what you have to write, you have to write cmd and then click on OK. Then you will get a black window like this. Okay, there what you have to write, you have to write Python hyphen version. As you can see here, I have written Python hyphen hyphen version, and then the latest version that it is showing on my machine after updation and all is 3.9.1. this is the latest version that I am having in my machine. Okay, then what you have to do is that, now coming back to IDE, which is PyCharm. Okay, PyCharm installation, how do you do that? So PyCharm is a cross-platform IDE and hence it can be installed on a variety of operating system. How do you do that? So installing PyCharm on Windows is very simple. What you have to do is that to install PyCharm on operating system, Windows operating system, you have to click on this link, www.jetbrains.com/PyCharm. Okay, jetbrains.com, remember it. Or you directly go to the Google and search for PyCharm installation or PyCharm download. It will take you to that link. Click on that and then, you know, update, follow the path. Okay, so to create the first program to PyCharm, follow the following step. What you have to do is that you have to click on the PyCharm editor, open the PyCharm editor, click on new project, option to create a new project, or in other case you can directly click on new. I'll be showing you that as well. Okay, then it will ask you to create a new project, click on that. It will ask you to name the project, right, and select the location to save the project. And we can save the newly created project at desired memory location or keep the file location as it is, but at least change the project default name, which is like, you know, untitled to first project, change it to a proper name. Sometimes you do not do that, right? And so that's the reason you have to do that, and then you click on the create button. So that is very much self-explanatory. Like here you need to change the, like, you know, name here, and then what you have to do is that you have to click on this create button. This is what you have to do. After that, what you have to do is that PyCharm installation, then click on the file menu and select new, and by clicking new option it will show various file formats. Select the Python file. I'll tell you how to do that. Okay, don't worry, just wait for a couple of more minutes. I'll take you to my PyCharm editor and will show you everything. So now when you click on this new button here, you can see a Python file will come up. Okay, you have to click on that and then name it like first program or anything, and then you are good to go. Okay, so now new Python file here, and then click write anything. So first program, you can simply write Python print hello world. It's very simple. Print, okay, all in small letter, then the round bracket, then within inverted comma, hello world or welcome to Python, whatever you want to write, and your program will be ready to run. Okay, when it comes to Visual Studio Code, how to do that, how to create that, and how to use online editor. So now what I will do is that I will take you to my desktop. Okay, and here what I will do is that first of all I'll take you to PyCharm editor. Okay, so here what you have to do is that click on new. Either you can create a new project or you can directly click on new. So when you click on new, you can see here Python file option is coming up, right? What I did is that I clicked on new file and then clicked on new, and here I can see Python file. Click on Python file, it will ask you for the name. So I'll write, you know, demo video. Okay, demo video lesson 1. Okay, this is what I will write. I clicked on it, a new file got opened. What I will do is that I will write here print and then welcome to young coders. I'll write like that, young coders. Okay, welcome to young coders, and then I'll right click over here, and then you can see run button is coming up, right? Run demo video lesson 1. Okay, I right click just here in the editor, in the coding area itself, and then you run, and you can see welcome to young coders is coming up. Okay, for you it might be coming down. Okay, since I'm making this video, so I have taken this up so that, you know, it doesn't get blocked because of my video which is also coming. So this is how you do it in PyCharm. Okay, I guess it is very simple. Now coming back to how to do it in Visual Studio Code. So when you go to Visual Studio Code, okay, you can create a folder which I have created. Okay, and then you can right click and directly open that folder using Visual Studio Code, and this you'll get something like this. You can create a new file like this and name it as, you know, like if I'll make this, so I'll make that demo video lesson 1.py. okay, I named it, and then here I will write print, and here I'll write welcome to young coders YouTube. Okay, or young coder YouTube, or you can directly write whatever you want to, and then click on run button. Okay, before that you make sure that you save it, otherwise Visual Studio Code is not going to get updated, and it is not going to run. So now you see here welcome to young coder is coming up over here, right? It is coming up over here. So this is how you do it. Now coming back to how to do it in online editor, so I'll take you to the Google Chrome. Here you write repl.it. okay, so you see the URL, it is repl.it, and then click enter. I don't know, my internet is, what happened to my internet, it seems to be fine only. Right, so it is taking some time to open, and then you have to log in. Okay, I'm already logged in. It will ask you to sign in. You sign in with your Google account, it's very simple. Then you click on this button called new repl, click on this button, and there you can see Python is already there. So if you are not finding it, then you write Python and it will come. Python, name it as, like, you know, demo video lesson 1. I'll write everything everywhere, same thing. Okay, and then it will open a window over here. Now here you need to understand how to do it. Okay, so for that what I'll be doing is that I'll be opening my pen. Okay, I'll be opening my pen so that you can see it. Okay, so now this is the coding area. Okay, this is the coding area. I hope you can see what I am writing. This is the coding area where you write your code. Okay, this is the file explorer. This is the file explorer where you can see main.py is already there. Here also the name will show. Okay, this is the name of the program that you are creating. Here is the run button, clicking on which the program will run over here. Okay, the program will run over here. This window is called as the console window. Okay, or the output window where you will be seeing all your output. Okay, we will be seeing all your output. I'll just show you everything how it is done. Okay, so what I will do is that here I will write print and I'll write hello world. Okay, and I'll click on run and you can see that hello world is coming over here. So very simple. If you do not want to download anything, if your specification of the machine is something like which is not supporting, if it is memory is already full, do not have to worry about it. Browser is already running in your machine. Open the browser, create an account in ripple.it and you are done. Okay, you can add file if you want to, you can add a folder if you want to, you can upload something here. This is the upload file, upload folder option, right? And then you have so many things. You can clear it here like this. Click on clear, it will get clear. Okay, if you want to see how you have, like, you do not have to save it because it automatically gets saved. And you want, in case you want to see your previous project, then you click on this three bar which are here, and then you can see my Ripple. So it will take you to your projects that you have created. So all the projects, like this is the project that I created just now. So I'll click on this one. Okay, and then what happens is that you can see this file which we already created. You can see hello world is already there, print hello world. So it is automatically getting saved. Your work is not going to get wasted. Okay, so that was a very quick video that we made on using, you know, installing HA. Coming back to Python, so you can write Python download. Okay, Python download, and it will take you to python.org. This is the page I was talking about. Here you can go to downloads. Okay, then the python.org, the download came into picture. You go down and you see what is the latest release that you are having. You are having 3.9.5. You can download this. Okay, coming back to PyCharm, so PyCharm download, you write directly like that. It is going to take you, the first link itself is jetbrains.com. Okay, click on that link and then it will take you to there, it will take you to that page where you can directly download it. Okay, do not download the professional edition, download the community edition, right? Do not download the community edition because it is like free trial, then again you have to pay something or otherwise, you know, the license will not be there. But the community edition is completely free and open source, you can download that. Okay, Visual Studio Code, you already know how to download it. In case you do not know it, then you will search about it. Okay, because Googling out is also a art. Okay, you need to learn that art. Okay, so that's all in this video. I'll suggest you that, you know, you can directly use an online editor, or otherwise, you know, go with PyCharm, or in case you want to go with Visual Studio Code also, you can go with that. Anything is fine. You can download Anaconda also. Now the next question people will ask is that, sir, can I use Anaconda? Yes, you can. You can. As long as you are comfortable with anything, you can go ahead with anything. Okay. I'll keep on changing the editor from time to time based on the need and based on the requirement. So you do not have to worry about. You just have to follow the code which I am writing. Anyway, I'll explain it to you everything. Okay. Thank you so much.